Sometimes when moving data from Excel to another system, you have this problem. So for example, I'm going to copy this. I need to put it here into my YouTube tags. These are clearly three separate tags. But when I paste it here, you'll see it puts it into one. Now the reason it does this is because it expects a comma after each tag. So what we're now going to do is show you how to quickly get that. So the first way we're going to do, use this flash fill. So here's my list. I'm actually just going to copy this, put it next door. So notice it's right next door. So that's column C, this is column D. All I'm going to do is, I know I need a comma there, so I'm going to put a comma. And then under data, you'll see there's an item here called flash fill. And when I click it, notice what it's done is it's gone, taken that whole list, and then just put commas at the end. With flash fill, always useful just to check that it has done it properly. But now when I do that same thing, I'm going to copy, I'm going to come here, and when I paste, notice because of the comma, it immediately sees it. So that's one way to do it. I'm just going to delete it. The other way is to use a formula. So in Excel, there's a function called text join. And all it asks you is, what is the delimiter? So in this case, we needed a comma, but maybe it's a semicolon or something like that. So I'm just going to put in inverted commas, a comma. What must happen with empty cells? We don't really have empty cells. I'm just going to leave this blank. And with the text, I can then just highlight the area. And what you'll see is it's already showing you here. It's just putting commas. When I say okay though, you'll see it's got the full list, but there's a comma between each one. And again, in this case, what I can do is I can copy it, come here, and when I paste it, it notices all the commas, and therefore it puts them into separate tags, in this case on YouTube.